Chris Chinnock here at CES 2024. I'm in the VueReal suite here in the Westgate. Just had a nice overview of what they're showing here. They are, well, people would think they are a microLED company. In fact, I think they're the better description of them is a microprinting company. So they obviously their technology is printing, and it's cartridge based. But the idea is that you can print not only micro LEDs, but all kinds of sensors and other electronics. Micro LEDs on glass transparent is one of the key things that they're working on, particularly for automotive. But in the future, this can be way more than this. And I think this is a really important trend that VueReal is also trying to ride as well. So what they're showing is several demos over here. I can't really get too close to them because this is still a proprietary suite here. But there's an automotive customer that they've talked about. Can't tell you too much about the display itself. And then they have some other transparent displays over here. You can kind of see in the background. It's kind of flashing a little bit in the video I can see here, but very bright, high transparency. Let's see, some of the numbers they told me here were they can do up to 50,000 nits if it's going to be on the front of an automobile, which is the kind of requirement, or 10,000 nits is more of a requirement for a tail light or something on the back of the vehicle. They are also one of the few companies that can do very small micro LEDs on the order of 20 microns or so. So very small. And they say a lot of other companies are using micro LEDs. Definition is a little bit fuzzy what that is, but they're generally larger than 20 microns. So the real value proposition of their printing technology is the ability to take the incoming wafers, whether those are micro LEDs or sensors, and to put them on their special cartridge technology. They do full characterizations and are able to then place basically all known good dye onto that cartridge, which then has a very high transfer rate to the final substrate, whether that's glass or LTPS or some other transparent substrate, or silicon even. They can do silicon as well. So some of the demos here are on LTPS, some are passive driven devices. And another part over here, they're showing some devices that are being developed for AR and VR. So these are much smaller. Now these are down to single micron devices. So in terms of business strategy, they focus on their printing technology. They source the micro LEDs from partners. They work with other suppliers on their tool set to develop it. And then they work with their customers, depending on the needs, to license equipment and to work with them on a royalty basis, basically a technology transfer. Again, depending on the application and the business model. But some of the stuff is looking pretty advanced. So this is all good news for the company, and we hope to learn more in the future. It's Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media.